Are you ready? Are you ready? For the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Norman.
You can get it walking. You can get it talking. You can get it working a plow. Matter of fact, I got it now. A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer. And the best cold beer is Vic. Victoria Bitter.
It's so hard to have a gay time on your own. It could be that grey chalk and biscuit coating. Could be that smooth toffee ice cream in the center, or that whole delicious golden K-Time taste.
So have a gay time on your own.
Streets Golden Gay Time, now available in smooth chocolate melt.
I'm Danny, and I'm here to call out all you crack pack bitches. You think I don't see you there? I'm the OG of this shit. But you come after the king, you better come correct. I'm Danny, motherfucker. Who are you? Crack pack. You smoke crack. You better watch your back.
Welcome, everybody. Man, I'm still weirded out by this. I need to do some rearranging. Looks freaky. Not that bad, though. Just unusual. And the lighting isn't the same either. I don't know what's going on. All we did was change a table. And everything's been thrown out. But how the bloody hell are you anyway? Hope you're doing fine tonight. On this fine, fine night, check out Downcast 4, says Snuggy Jr. Do check it out. Hashtag Weirdcroft. Yeah, it's disconcerting, Tacitus. You're right. It's unusual, but you can't sit at an angle on a square table, on a rectangle table, and I don't have any room in here to angle it. I'm just going to have to... I didn't move out of my dungeon. I mean, the same cottage. The cottage is large enough to house a beautifully handcrafted Australian pine table. But I'm going to have to figure something out. I don't know. Might be time for a little bit of a revamp. You could just move the camera right. I can't. Because I would need a tripod for that. I suppose I could hold it like that. Hey, everyone. Phenomenal. Bogans. Woo. I guess I could get a tripod. How are you all? We got Clint coming on tonight. excited. I haven't hung out with Clint in a while. He doesn't come onto YouTube much anymore. I don't know. Did he give up the YouTube game altogether? I'm going to have to ask him these tough questions. And, you know, as Mo said yesterday, Clint is an iconoclast. He is a rabble rouser. He is a cage rattler. So we're going to get some crazy hot fire tonight from Clint Stoker. But I'll send him the link in a little bit. I'm not going to do the 15-minute thing, but I'll send it to him. I want to say some stuff. I don't want to drag Clint into it. When I talk to Clint, I want to hang out. I want to have fun. Like I do with Ellie Frog Capo. A new name every day for this man. And I approve. Oh, no, I didn't upload his logo. What a shambles tonight is. I've been busy. You guys don't know how busy I am. I was up till 12:30 in the a.m. last night working on Pain of Death. He's gotten two for the year. Congratulations. Jeremy Burtz is here too. It is ostensibly Weeb Thursday, although I don't think we're doing any Weebery tonight. But Mo can't make it tonight. Justice for Mo, the gatekept, the unsuperboganed. Thank you very much yesterday for all the generosity of everyone attempting to assist Mo, even though we ended up failing in the end. Haldir is here. Hyper Wizard is here. Look at this. Fabrizio Aiello. I hope I got your name right. Very happy to see you here in the chat, man. He says he's looking forward to this, as am I. Like I said, I haven't caught up with Clint since the last time. I think he sent me a whole bunch of candy, American candy, which I liked about a third of. I don't know. I like Australian lollies. Don't take that out of context, by the way. We have a different vernacular down here. Dojo Kun in the house. Sumo Thori's here. Snucky Jr. Citizen Ronan. Raiden Radio. Hello, you fine folks. How right back to you. 40% Zed calling me out. A little bit. I'm disconcerted by the video. It never seems to be where I want it, so it's hard to get started, but... we are also joined by the Rumble Gang, Tassus Jones primarily over there. He likes tonight's thumbnail, those old school diving suits. Yeah, I don't know much about it because, like a pleb, I have not read Downcast yet, but I plan on rectifying that tonight, even. Hopefully, we'll see. We got Jake Martin here too, Snuggy Jr. Did I say sumo? I think I did. Got awesome one. We have the one, the only, Mr. Corey Barton, who said manga was awesome. Manga is the greatest? I don't know about that. I mean, that's I'm not anti-manga, but I don't know if it's the greatest. It's certainly doing the best. He says Berserk, Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Z. Isn't that a cartoon? Ghost in the Shell looks kind of cool, but anyway, not that kind of lollies. Any Australian in the chat knows what I'm talking about. I mean, you just got chocolate. The British call it sweek. What? Berserk better than Lucent? Well, that's fair enough, actually. I mean, what's Berserk up to? 200 friggin' chapters? I'll give it that. That's allowed, but only because I've just only gotten started. And I have to work a day job. So did I skip you, Henry Bemis? I apologize. My track, everything is wrong tonight. My trackpad is not in the right place. I'm put off. But the Lucent wasn't being put off. Where's my window? Oh, there it is. Check it out. I got another backer. Woohoo! I love that. I think it's because they sent an update out today. 863 backers. Ooh, very close to 70,100. Check it out. I sent out an update today. I have finished the last spread. Look at Ella there shooting off into the sky like a beautiful shooting star, fiery shooting star, like a reverse comet full of fire. But it's all dream fire. See how she kind of dragged the building and the crane with it, and she's sort of bending the buildings here. It's all make-believe, or is it? Nice effects. Thank you, Corey. Yeah, I'm happy with this. I'm happy how it came out. I like the colors. I like the effects. You know, I never really know what I'm going to do until I get in there and do it and see if it looks good. And if it looks good, I'm also off-putting, says Sumo. Well, that's true. Once Ella starts cutting men in half with her mind, Lucent will be back on top. I think that would be possible. I do think that would. I just had to think about that. I hadn't contemplated that power, but I think it's feasible. Yeah, there's all sorts of things I might not have thought about yet, but I got to sort of slot it into the power sets that I know of. But excitingly, check this out, actually. So all last night, I was doing this. Where is it? I can't zoom in any closer because then you'll get all the secrets of the stew and the sausage and how it's made. But these are Joe's notes, final notes, the final call for Pain of Death. Everything in green is stuff that I said, yep, double thumbs up. Good on you, Joe. Some of the changes he made were so good. I'm like, get an editor, because I must have rewritten this book 100 times by now, you know, tweaking, but still things get through. Get an editor. The stuff in orange or yellow is like, let's discuss. Not saying no, just let's discuss so we can, you know, figure this out. And then the stuff in red is stuff that I have to go off and do, like maybe, I don't know, do a little thing, change a sound effect, whatever. I did all of that last night. It took me till 12:30, climbed into bed, tired, like I'd done a full day's work. And I had water powers would be very strong cutting tools. That is true. And hydraulics as well. So, yeah, that was something I did last night, which I'm proud of. I've got a meeting with Joe in a couple of days. Once everything's finalized, we send everything off to our good friend, Mr. Eric Weathers. And he said, I mean, he could knock this out maybe in a week. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how busy he is. But it would be fantastic to get that out of the way. And then it's just formatting, pre-press, any final edits. And we're golden like Pony Boy. So that's a cool little update. Someone want to show you? No. Oh, another little update. I had this idea. It's part of what I want to talk about tonight. I've been doing these videos where I do these breakdowns of the books. And I thought, you know, it would be cool, because no one's going to come back after after the fact, after I've done a stream and watch, you know, an hour long stream of me waffling on like an idiot. It'd be cool if I do a little breakdown of all the books that I'm reading and liking into kind of a blog. On this isn't designed or anything, I just sort of started putting it up onto a little blog on my site. So, you know, it's a little breakdown, it'll have the synopsis, who was in it and what. I haven't written why I like it, and just a little thing here. And you know, I could imagine eventually it would be like a whole page, you know, of the comics that I thought were good. It's a cool way of making content, and it's, you know, it could be a nice little resource for anyone who's always out there saying, oh, indie comics is so hard to get into, I never know, you know, what to read or what's good out there. It's so hard to know what, get past the shilling, get past the bluster. You know, so it's sort of like a book club, I guess, of you know, the books I liked. And it's sort of like, it ties in with the YouTube channel with the strings, and then eventually I want to move into doing it with shorts. So hopefully it grows, hopefully it becomes something, hopefully something positive, interesting, comic book related, which is getting sparser out there these days in them streets. Got the Gooch in the house. Yo, what's up, Gooch? Diabolical Souls, everyone go subscribe. And to Dean as well. Dean just got monetized the other day. Congratulations, Dean. I'm sorry I couldn't make your stream the other day, but I still had to work, and yeah, couldn't be helped. But I was watching on the side for a little bit. So before we bring Clint on, And I said to Clint, I might bring you on like in 15 minutes or half an hour or something. So he's cool. He'll just come in whenever I send him the message. I saw this earlier. This is that Star Wars girl. So apparently now she had a press pass for C2E2. Everyone knows by now, I assume, that Shane, John, and Ethan were denied after initially being approved their booth at C2E2. Now Anna had a press pass and it's been canceled. And I mean, my initial thought was, all right, well, what did they say? Is it, you know, another one? Are you harassing or something like that? They actually said, I'm not diverse enough. I mean, which is an interesting thing to say. And then Umbrella guy asks about it as well. He says, it's wild that cons ban people and remove press passes. What the F? Press on our terms isn't press, it's propaganda. So they had previously approved it, then put it under review when they found out I was friends with John, Shane, and Ethan. Total BS. So, I mean, it seems to me, yeah, like over there at that company, it's there's sort of persona non grated John, Shane, and Ethan, and now are playing the guilt by association game. But any one of their known, like it's like that thing, you know, their known associates. They meant marriage bloodline isn't diverse enough. I said something along the lines of, you know, like diversity is not, it doesn't mean diversity at all. And someone said here, oh, you know, it's only diverse. And it's not even that. It's you're in the cult or you're not. You 100% align with hating white people, and you know, there's a million genders, and men are women and women are men and all that sort of stuff, or you're out of the cult. And if you're not in the cult and we know about it, you're not welcome. So that's the situation as it is here. And it just got me thinking after everything that's been going on this last week, you know, with the culture surrounding popular entertainment and comics in particular. What do you do about this? Anna looks like she's gonna fight. She says it's on, and then puts a angry swearing emoji. And that seems to be what I know. Like Anna will go on and yell at these people in an entertaining way. That's certainly what John did after C2E2. And I was just sort of wondering about that. You know, it's been going on for so long now. I mean, I know, look, cancel culture has been around forever. It's been around, you know, going all the way back that there's ever been civilization. But now you've got it, you know, it really gets fueled by crazily by Twitter, and we've got the new diversity woke brand. You know, what's the best way to fight it? I'm not going to tell anyone how they should fight it. Commando is a great... I was thinking about watching Commando again. It's been so long. It is so 80s. It's kind of campy almost. But it's still good. Like every single thing comes with a line, an Arnie line. Diversity is a religion of hate. Yeah, it is. You either accept the whole ball of intersectional wax or you're an enemy. That's Sith level behavior. Only Siths deal in absolute, says Jake Martin. I'm more of the mind to kind of kill them with kindness. And when I say kill them, I don't actually expect to harm them in any way, personally. But I think if enough people are doing a similar thing, then they might, and I don't say will, but might be able to tap in to this sort of thing. It's like, kill them with kindness, defeat them with greatness. And the way you do that is you have a secret weapon. And that secret weapon that we've seen, you look at everything that the woke has touched over the last 20 years or however long it's been a thing, is this cult can't create. It can't create anything. Everything it touches, it destroys. So it may be the whole kill them with kindness approach. And I'll say what I mean by that. I don't mean be kind to them. I mean, don't engage in their game. Like, when you push back on them, they're just going to push back even harder. Citizen Ronan has a very good idea. The secret weapon is Roka Force. That's definitely part of it. But I'm just sort of thinking, like, every time you sort of push on them and get, sort of like fight fire with fire with them, that only fuels what they're doing even more. So, I guess what I mean is create, make great things. And yes, it's going to take a very long time because you don't have access to all of the things that they've taken over, all of the institutions and structures and marketing platforms and everything they've taken over. But ultimately, at the end of the day, even though your thing is going to be smaller, at least it's yours. At least you don't have to bite your tongue and ignore all the craziness that they're doing on the side while you're kind of taking in the paycheck. Bancroft probably has a hang in there poster. I would have that. I think Shant does have one of them that he painted himself with a tiger. Henry says, you can't defeat SJWs with SJW tactics. That's called a ferric victory. Is it ferric or pyrrhic? Can't remember. But, I was just thinking, I was chatting with Jake and I was like, man, this last week, with Ed Piskor and everything, it's like, it's really shown how, comics is such a, especially indie comics, it's such a small thing that if you, and it's become so tribal and so cliquish that if you end up getting declared persona non grata, you are an unperson, then you really are like that group is just like, or you just go away into the desert and die now. That's really how it's ended up. And it's a real shame. And it's really difficult to stay positive and be, uplifting and create and creative in that environment. But if you're constantly at war and you're constantly in a battle, it's hard to create joy and happiness and stuff. I really dig what Dark Gift is doing with the cockfight. That's awesome. More stuff like that, less engaging with it, just even engaging with, obviously don't try to participate. It can be difficult sometimes in terms of like commenting and, whatever. Try not to engage with the cancel culture, the guilt by association. That's what we see going on here, but it goes on everywhere. No side is immune to it. No side is 100% innocent of it. The group shunning, all that sort of stuff. Positivity instead, fun, building, creating. This is the stuff that they can't do. They can't have fun because they're insufferable weirdos. They can't build up. They can only tear down. We can build up if we stay focused on that sort of stuff. And by we, I mean whatever. Indie creators, indie fans, whatever you want to call yourself today, I'm cool with. And for me personally, like I never wanted to create conservative content, even though I have in the past. I'm sure like people will call it conservative. I might again in the future. It was never my intention to go out and do that. It was more like you should be able to be a conservative and a creative at the same time. And what I'm going to do with that is just like, I'm going to make my book. I'm going to make it as good as I possibly can. And, hopefully who I associate with and what I believe won't be an issue. It probably will to certain people like C2E2 and others. But I can't
I can't just. No, I can't be at war constantly, and make something really cool. I think at least that's just me. That's just me. Maybe others can. I can't. But that's what I'm going to be doing. And I see a lot of others out there doing the same thing. And I'm pretty sure Clint Stoker is one of them. I'm pretty sure that's his. Like he's just sort of super focused on his book and making cool stuff. And yeah, that's where I'm going as well. This was fun today. Jake is back on a stream, doing an update, showing off his carnal stuff. Stuff like this, I love. It's not popular. Sorry, Jake. It's not you. It's just like this stuff isn't super popular. It won't get you all the clicks and the views and everything. But you're just going to have to deal with that and grow. And, you know, everyone... you know, anyone who's super famous and big and did something amazing, they started somewhere as an unknown person. And there's no reason why that can't be me or you or anyone. But for me personally, if I'm constantly sort of like punching back at the BS out there, then, yeah, you know, you're just kind of dealing with the counterpunches the whole time. Jake has a great taste in rap, says Kelsey. Kelsey's back as well. I'm always just, the sun is always shining when Kelsey's back. It was great on Greybeards. It was the first Greybeards I'd watched in about 3 weeks. And it was great. It's not popular. Bankrupt quote on Carnal. I didn't mean it like that, but it was great. Do go sign up to Carnal. Look at this. Looks fantastic. I'm going to try and do a piece of art for Jake for his book that he wants to do at the Heroes Con. I mean, it's not going to be super duper intricate, Jake, but I was actually thinking maybe of doing a version in my Ricky Gervais ripoff style. I don't know. What do you think of that? If that's a good idea or a bad idea? Because then you could even animate it if you wanted to. But yeah, this looks like a lot of fun. So do go sign up for Carnal. And if that does look like a giant blue dick axe to you, you probably won't be disappointed. Yeah. Just have fun, says Jake. That's what I'm trying to do. That's what I'm trying to do. And comics are fun. And it's you know, recently it's been hard to remember that. But you notice whenever something fun does come around, like the cockfight, everyone just gravitates towards it. So, you know, that's a very promising thing. And, you know, I'm certainly be trying to do my part however I can in my small way. Continue on doing that. What else have I got here to share? Oh, Jaeger Bomb. Look how close it is. This is before we just get Clint on. Actually, I can probably send Clint the link. Let me pop my little headphones in so we don't get an echo. Look at awesome one. What a quote. Whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy. I nearly got through that unscathed. Think about such things. Yeah, what's that quote I shared the other day? The soul is dyed with the color of your thoughts. Shanth put me onto that. That was friggin' brilliant. Amanda, 97%. He did have to extend it, which is fine, which is good. And he's a mere, what is that, 180, no, 123 something. Don't make me do maths. No, oh yeah, no, that is, this is the US dollars, yeah. Awesome, awesome. Well done. Well done, our good friend Donald. I grabbed mine. I hope you grabbed yours. And, oh, I forgot to send, I got to send the link to Clint, and then I forgot to do it. Idiot. Where's my Twitter? Twitter. Clint Stoker, come on down. There he is. Here he is. All right. He haseth the link. Excelente. Blood Realm as well. We had Robert on the other day. That is a big goal, $10,000. That ain't nothing to sniff at. The man put his... he put his worth out there on the internet and asked, am I worth this? And it looks like he is. It looks like he is going to get there. It's, I mean, it's still $2,000-ish dollars left to go, but I'm confident he will get there. And I was congratulating him. Man, he's up to 18 issues. That is, in comics, that is legit. Mr. Clint Stoker. How you going, Clint?
Hey, good. How you doing, Bancroft? Do I sound okay?
You sound a
Do I sound broken? It sounds weird to me.
Yeah, it sounds, you know, it sounds very 2010.
Yeah, let me work on that for a minute.
You work on that. I'm shouting out Blood Realm just in the meantime. Right. Actually, and also I'm gonna shout out Von Klaus. Check this out. Terror in the Trenches Volume 2 signups. Terror in the Trenches was so cool. The art on it was just mind-blowing. Oh my god. But I felt like, oh, there's this whole big world that I'm getting a little taste. I know the characters, I know of them. I want more. I want to see more. So yeah, excellent, excellent. Is there a link here? Does he have a link? There we go. There's a link. Maybe pop the link in. Everyone go sign up to Terror in the Trenches too. Von is one of the best of us. He is a fantastic writer. Kelsey, Clint, the artist of your wonderful Dracula cover, says, you sound terrible, but you look great.
Thanks, Kelsey. I don't know. I don't know what's happening.
Yeah, you sound like you're streaming from a tin cup or something.
I don't get it. I selected the correct. I'm so sorry. This feels
you really am
amateurish. Thing. Yeah,
it's you been a come little back while. To YouTube.
I know.
Are you YouTubing anymore? Do you do any videos or anything anymore?
No, I don't think I've made a video in at least 6 months.
How do you feel? How does it feel? You're like, I got out.
Actually, it's been great. I don't know what to do about the audio, so I'm going to pretend it sounds fine. I'm
just don't worry about it. If anyone complains, we'll just say, eh.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Yeah, I mean,
she'll be right.
Yeah, it's actually been really nice. As I'm sure you know, when you're making videos and trying to just feed the beast with content,
that's what it is.
Yeah, it feels like, and at some point, you know, when you're growing, it's great, and then it's addictive. But when you're not, it feels like you're you know, bailing out your rowboat with a cup or a teaspoon or something. It just feels like you keep throwing stuff at it. It's actually been really nice not making YouTube videos and feeling like I have to. And I got my MBA. So I, you know, was working on that instead. Yeah, I have been.
Yeah, man. I tried it. It was fun. I'm talking about the YouTube thing.
Yeah.
I had massive success. Tens of millions of views and all that sort of stuff. But you know, now I look back on some of the stuff I was talking about, it's like, wow, I thought I kind of cared at the time. I really couldn't care less about any of this. And it's like, oh, the stuff I care about, I mean, there is an audience, but it isn't massive, and you don't have to chase any algorithms for it. It really is just sort of, I like indie comics. I like cool indie comics. Yeah. I like reading cool new stories that no one else really has heard of or seen yet.
Yeah, 100%. And you know, when you're enjoying making videos and stuff, that's awesome.
I was. Yeah. And I'm going to get back to it as well, but it's going to be focused on indie comics. I don't know how successful it's going to be. This man right here, Jeremy, he's doing great with it. He's covering cool TV shows. He started with From House of the Dragon. He's now onto the new Shogun series. And I saw he's got a good crowd watching his stuff on that. So, yeah. But, yeah, keeping up with the Joneses on YouTube, it is. I mean, it's basically a full-time job.
It is. Yeah. You, on top of your existing full-time job. And you know, when it's fun, I remember, the first 3 years I would get such a high out of, you know, what am I going to talk about? I have something to say about this. And it was not effortless, but I just loved it. It was so much fun. I just enjoyed it. So yeah, when you're on that, go for it. It stopped being fun for me. So I was like, I'm not gonna like force myself to do it anymore.
Yeah, that was it. Even some of them, you know, depending on how much editing there was, I was like spending an hour and a half a day, every day. And you kind of count up all those hours and you're like, oh man, how much more of my book could I have drawn or colored or whatever? And, you know, so, but I still think the marketing side is super important. So you have to do something. I've been looking at, you know, other avenues, digital as an option, still trying to figure that out. But Rini's doing something on that front. Chad Townsend is doing something on that front. I don't know if you're doing anything on that front, but there's other ways to make this work you know, especially for those of us who do have the day job, we don't have unlimited hours.
Right. Yeah. And you want to, I don't know, for me, it was like, do I want to spend more time or the little free time I have, do I want to spend it making stories? And what does that look like? You know, in a practical sense though, you have to do marketing. That's not a surprise. Yeah. Or you can just tell stories. Like I'd written a couple books before I was ever doing YouTube and, you know, I still had books. Like, I still wrote them, but not nearly as many people read them, you know? So if you want people to read
catch 22,
right? Yeah.
You gotta catch 22. Yeah. So I don't know. I was talking about this the other week. I liked how on Webtoon, so on YouTube, most of the time people will back you because it's a mixture of, they think your stuff looks cool and they like you.
Yeah.
And then you'll get a lot of things happening where like, oh, I don't like you, so I'm not backing your stuff, even though I think your stuff looks good, or I really like him, and even though his stuff looks terrible, I'm still going to back him anyway.
Yeah.
There's a lot of that going on. And then you know, and YouTube being the beast that it is, you also get like, oh, I don't like that guy. He doesn't like that guy. And he hangs out with them and I don't like him. And you know, and then you kind of get welled up in it. And
it ended up, you know, there was one point when every time I posted a video, I would dread it because I would get refunds. And it didn't matter. It didn't matter what I talked about. I'm not kidding.
No way. Well, that sort of goes against everything that we're trying to do in marketing our books.
Well, it wasn't, you know, obviously under normal circumstances, it'd be fine. But it's just how it was for a little while. So I don't know. That was kind of the beginning of, well, let me think about this. Do I really want to post this video? But, you know, having a super late campaign put you top of mind, you know. And so now I have literally the last prints. We had a print set from Fatal. Those are packaged up. As soon as we're done, I'm printing off the shipping labels, and Fatal's 100% fulfilled. Incredible.
How does it feel to get that 500-pound gorilla off your back?
You know, it was such a long, because I've been fulfilling it for the past year, really, a little over a year. But it was like waiting on head sketches. You know, I shipped everything out that I possibly could. And it was like, well, head sketches and then signed prints and just the logistics of getting those across the country first. And so it feels good. I expected like a better, you know, like, oh, I'm done today. But it's been such a long, slow process that maybe when I go to the post office tomorrow morning, it'll be like, all right, I did it.
The final Fatal.
Yeah, right. So. But yeah, it feels good. I love seeing, you know, I never get sick, tired of people getting books. Even you know, as recently as last week, people getting books and posting, hey, I read Fatal. I loved it, you know, and that never gets old.
It doesn't. And it's like a big shot in the arm of energy. And you're like, oh, wow. Yeah, and you remember
this is why
you're doing this in the first place. is to, you know, have readers read your stuff and enjoy it and talk about it. And yeah, I couldn't agree more on that stuff. So, you know, it's we are crazy wanting to do comic books, but I think it's the best kind of crazy, because it doesn't make any real financial sense or sanity sense or anything like that, but we do it anyway because, you know, I don't know if you're like me, I want to tell a story. I have a story. I think it's great. I think people will love it.
Yeah.
And I want to get it out there. So
yeah, you know, I went through and I was doing business school and I kept thinking, how do I apply this to comics? And in hindsight, you know, as I was going through it, I was realizing you wouldn't. It doesn't make business sense like at all.
No, you think about the hourly rate
because you love
put into your work. Uh-huh. No one works for this hourly rate. It's like a cents an hour or something like that, you know. It's,
no. Yeah. And just the tremendous amount of work in making a book, but it's super satisfying. I mean, when you see the print file come together, that to me is like one of the big points. When you have the print file together ready to go off to the printer, there's something really satisfying about that. Obviously seeing it when it's in print, that's amazing. There are a few times like that that just are like, okay, this is the high I'm chasing.
Well, we all have that dream as well, that, you know, one day when it's all said and done, the people out there will see, they will recognize, you know, how the glory of my work. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it'll just become this big social contagion that everyone will recognize. Then one day you will get rich off it and famous and get all the glory that you always deserve, but just, you know, never happened. Everyone does have that hope. And I think everyone should, you know, kind of keep that in the back of their mind, you know, as they work along and, you know, struggle to get a handful of people to pay attention to what they're doing. But you seem to be headed down that path with Downcast, because now I have a confession to make. I haven't read Downcast still. We're up to 4 books and I've been hanging out with you and I've just been hearing great stuff about it. And for just whatever reason, you know, I just never grabbed it. And the other weird thing about it is I love the genre.
Yeah.
The art looks amazing. I don't know. I don't know what it is. It's but just one of those things.
I've got a pile of unread books too. So yeah, no judgment.
I plan on Snuggie is shaming me. Yeah. I plan on rectifying that. And I've been making a conscious effort over the last 6 months to steer away from talking about what people are doing and talking about books and what's in the books and books and stuff like that. So as part of that, I do plan on grabbing Downcast now, finally, after all these years. Now, the question though I have is, so you've got an Indiegogo campaign here. I've pinned it in the chat for everyone. It's also in the description. But you also have your own website.
Yeah, what does it look like right there?
You
know,
you joined Eric and myself, Mandy Summers, and a bunch of others who said, screw these platforms who, you know, shadow ban and engage in weirdness, and created your own site. Is it better for you if I back on your site or an Indiegogo? Do you want me to back an Indiegogo to pump the numbers up, or what do you want?
Yeah, I don't know. It's hard to say. You're free to do whatever you want. Part of me wants it on Indiegogo just because I want to get the number up higher. That's the only reason. But in theory, I'm sure I keep more money, a little bit more money on the website. So it doesn't really matter. I think the difference is negligible. But so I don't know. Do with that what you will. The Indiegogo part of me was, you know, because I've had so many campaigns on there, I was scrolling through them, and I want to have Downcast 4 on there just because I want the whole series on there. I don't want
it
to just
look like it
disappeared. Well. Yeah.
It's always been there.
So yeah, I mean, that's, I just thought I have to do it on Indiegogo. And there were, you know, several backers that didn't find it on the website, didn't come across. I mean, you're still, it is what it is, but so people are getting it on Indiegogo that didn't know that it was that I had it on the website, you know. So
we have to remember that not everyone is paying attention to the same things that you might be paying attention to.
Yep.
That's why I always advocated for putting your book in as many places as is feasible for you, whether that's Indiegogo, Kickstarter, or Fund My Comic, because you just never know. And to me, I didn't see any downside in terms of, look, if you pick up another 50 readers, that's another 50 readers. That's freaking awesome.
Yeah.
So
this nearly $4,000, that's makes
crazy.
It makes a big difference to me.
I've heard the argument. Yeah, I've heard the arguments. People want to have people like that. You know, you can see everything that you've backed in one place, and I agree with that. That's a very convenient thing to have, and you know, you everything you back is all on one site. You can go through it. I mean, totally get with that. So, and you know, and other people's like, look, I've always just only ever backed on Kickstarter, or I'm not backing on either of these platforms anymore. I'm a Fund My Comic 100% through and through kind of guy. I think it's just good you give options to everyone. We have that's a cool thing about this technology we have now. Is options. You know, we don't have to go through what was set up before. We can sort of forge our own path, and including your own website. So all right, I think I might back on Indiegogo then, just for ease, and also you know, so I can say that you got a Bancroft bump, even if though it's literally a Bancroft bump. Dojo says I backed on both sites, therefore got both covers. Ooh, you got a different cover on Indiegogo.
They're the same. So the one difference I will say on the website is that I can't remember if it's still on there, but there was like a threshold. If you passed it, you get a free trading card pack. So that's not on Indiegogo. And you know, the backers that backed on the website are going to get their books shipped out first. Again, the difference isn't going to be massive, but they're the ones that backed initially, you know, that initial launch. And so I want to make sure that they are, that they're not missing out on anything.
Jason in the chat says, hey, I'm a member. Yeah, we had a great big membering yesterday, and you were swept up in it. We were trying to get Mo Biggs a membership, and out of 39 members that were gifted, it was crazy. He didn't get one of them, and he's here every day. So we didn't know what was going on there. He says, didn't know. Anyway, back at number 75. I love you. Jason is so nice.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Jake Martin, back at number 76.
Jake. Appreciate that.
Hold on.
Let's move it.
Get off the dollary dues. You were under 4,000. Now, if I do a little refresh, you are now over 4,000, 70 backers. Love to see it.
Thanks, everybody. Even with the terrible audio, I appreciate it.
It's in spite of the terrible audio.
You're right. Yeah.
They're pushing through. So, all right, we are up to the fourth book in the series. Do you want to give a little rundown on where we're up to at the moment and what people to expect in this book?
Yeah, so we should for sure watch the trailer, because this is my best trailer I've ever done, but I'm happy to do a pitch too.
All right. Let me I gotta put it into a different browser so I can actually play the audio. Forgot to download the trailer. I'm so out of practice.
No worries.
All right, sharing screen. There it is. Audio. All right, let's hit it.
Every waking moment, Jax and Monstro are hunting for your friends. It's just a matter of time before all those supposed gods are all dead. But you don't really care about them, do you, Carver? Don't ask me why I'm here. Why I came for you instead of them. I ask the questions now, because I need to know. What are you hiding? And what's on the other side of that window? My home has become a hunting ground.
Very go. I don't know if this is just a little laggy on my end, but yeah.
Yeah, I've got, I got like the little, your internet is dying symbol on my thing there. Yeah. No,
all good. I apologize. Yeah. No worries. Yeah. I'll give you a little, I mean, this is up to what would be chapter 10 of the story or issue 10. And so it's kind of wild to think about it because it covers a lot of story up to this point, but, basically, it's humanity has moved up to the clouds. So they're living in a floating city in the sky. There's our characters are Joanne and Jax, their brother and sister, and they're working to pay off their father's prison sentence because that's how it works in this city. And they get
corporate prisons.
Exactly. I gotta earn that money. But they get the power to control gravity for one day. By total accident, and immediately they're going to exploit that to try and save their father from prison. So it's very much the way I put this together is it's, you know, I took inspiration from some of my favorite video games from like the PS1 era. I felt like Jet Moto, Final Fantasy 7. You might not see any of this in it, but initially when I was, you know, putting together the idea for Downcast, that's where I was. And then of course it's about family and yeah, it's super fun. And so in this fourth installment, there's always been sort of a balance between what is real and what is fantasy, what's belief. And this is where they all kind of come to a head and all of it's real. And so you'll see this, they're basically at war with these unseen gods that are starting to appear. That's Agara there, the alligator.
And, I was just wondering when you're going to get up to the giant alligator. You know, you were telling this story, and I'm like, okay, but where does the giant alligator man come into this?
Right. Yeah, they worship these different gods, like the goddess of the stratosphere that controls gravity and everything. And so there's these other gods or like lesser gods up here, and some of them are in the form of animals. They have different things. They're the gods of kind of strange, unusual things. And it makes for a lot of fun. I can't tell you what the alligator is god of because it will ruin the story. But that is right at the end of the chapter that Eric Weathers draws. That is revealed. And I'm excited about that one. It's awesome. So.
is this Eric's art here?
No, this is Nacho's art. Eric's, if you keep scrolling down, you'll see images from his chapter.
Hang on. And at the bottom here.
Oh, I don't see scrolling at all. So maybe you are showing his. I can't even, I don't know if it's me. I can't see the scrolling happening.
I know what's happening. Oh, yeah. My freaking internet. What is going on? Can you hear me? Let me turn up my...
You sound fine. That's definitely Eric's art right there.
I can see... Hang on. You know what I'm going to do? Every time this happens, I'll play a video. And I'm gonna do a little refresh. And we'll see how we go there. What video can I play? How about this one?
She may be the face I can't forget. The trace of pleasure or regret, maybe my treasure or the price I have to pay.
It's romantic.
Well, yeah. It's my wife and her obsession with lawnmowers. I don't know where she gets it. All right, I think we're back now. I'm not
saying that looks good.
You know why it does that?
Yeah. So I can confirm this is Eric Weathers' art.
All right. Yeah, because this looked different to me. And I was like, surely that's Eric. And I realized, I'm just freaking.
And it worked out. I don't know if you're like me when I read a comic series and they change from artist to artist, which happens, you know, really regularly in the comic book industry. It's really off-putting. I don't like that. And so for me, because we're switching artists, it has to be different time, different place. So this is all a flashback from the Monstros history. He's the diver guy, is the mantra that shows up in volume three rather. And Eric knocked it out of the park. Absolute professional. But this story was
so good, it's crazy. I'm actually really jealous of his art that he's been showing off on Battle Brick Road.
Oh, too. Yeah.
It's nuts. And now he's got Farah working on the colors. Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
Get out of here.
Yeah, he's doing amazing. So yeah, I'm really, really happy to have it's, you know, it's a full 20 pages that Eric does in here. It's super crucial to the story, even though it's a flashback. So it's very important. So yeah, that's a fun one. I wrote it so that it could have worked as a one shot, perhaps. But yeah, it needs to be right there in the story. It's awesome. And this is Nacho Lazaro. I've been working with him for years since the beginning. Good. Yeah,
it's so good. And he's gotten tons better too, as well. I can see.
Yeah, he's improved. And it's been what, 5 years? 4 years, something like that we've been working together, and he's been on Downcast since the beginning, and you can see that progression. He still has that recognizable style that's very much not
sort of it reminds me a little bit of Kennedy. Mel was saying that earlier to me. It's very loose,
yeah,
and it's more about the overall thing, but man, it looks so good. Some of these panels and pages they really, like that one in particular, it's just,
yeah, that's great.
It's a banger. Look at the expression in that face.
Yeah,
it's freaking great. So if you are a new reader such as myself, what is the best thing to do here?
Yeah, so this is probably right here, the Downcast New Readers Bundle. If you just want the books, the most economical way to get there, this is it. So we did a reprint of volume 1 and volume 2 into one book, which is Downcast Collection 1, just that cover on the left. So that's a 120 page graphic novel right there. And then that'll catch up on the first two, sort of the origin story. And then, yeah, you've got volumes 3 and 4 there.
What are you going to do when you're up? How many volumes are you going to do? Do you know?
I want to do one more. I want to do 5.
Okay. Well, then they're not that far off.
No. Yeah. It's close. So, but yeah. And then we'll see. I know people are like, oh, you're going to make an omnibus. I don't think so. That's very unlikely to make an omnibus. I had to reprint 1 and 2 because they sold out, over years. And those were, for indie comic, they were, reasonable print runs, but yeah, so we had to go back to print. There's which is good. The readers win because you're getting it for a very affordable price. It's super nice, high quality, soft cover comic book, so graphic novel rather.
I think I want a t-shirt to go with my books. So I think I'm gonna go in here. I'm gonna get myself a t-shirt. The cool thing is now, I can splurge a little bit because I'm saving on the shipping by getting everything sent through RJ. So I don't have to pay too exorbitant. I just got to get rid of that friggin' tip. Indiegogo.
That's how they get you.
It was $32. $32.
That's crazy. And not only that, but they're not even indexing the campaign, which I knew would be the case. That's how it is for, I think, just about everybody now.
Go.
Yeah. But hey.
Right, I think we're good.
Thanks for your support.
Good. And submit payment.
All right, everybody.
I get to type in. We just got a backer here, I think. Daniel Russell.
Hey.
Number 79.
Thank you, Daniel. Appreciate that.
Where's mine? Hang on, I gotta go to my thing. Contributions. Where am I? I am. Let me type it in here. Backer number. Hang on, if I can type. How do you spell backer again? 80. Oh, that makes sense.
With an AR. There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. Now it's backer, mate. Actually, I gotta do it. Backer. Yeah, backer. Back a number 80, mate.
There you go.
Finally. Yes.
Back at 80.
Hail Mo.
Thank you.
There we go. Mo Biggs is here. I know it's just so long. And I tell you what, I'm You know, when I first came into all this scene, I was excited and enthused and crazy. Everyone else just backing everything left, right, and center. And, you know, I got a lot of trash. I got a lot of junk sitting on my shelf because of that. And it's, you know, I got a lot of good stuff too. I got great stuff actually, but it was few and far between. Now I'm a bit more reserved. I wait. Yeah. I wait to see if people like tell me just of their own volition. Oh, that's a great series. You gotta read that. That's really good. And ever since I started doing that, you know, it's been getting a lot better, and I've really been enjoying it. Pretty much most books. Now it's kind of surprising when I get a book and I'm like, oh,
yeah,
didn't turn out
right
as well as I hoped it would. It's actually a rarity now.
That's good. Yeah. I know I've got tons. And to be fair, I haven't read like Grokken. I haven't read Grokken yet. I have the first two books.
Do you have the Ashcans?
I don't remember.
The little ones.
Probably not, I guess. I think I just got the books. So I have the first two. I haven't read,
I read it. I read both books, the first one twice. And I was like, I feel like I'm missing something. And I think he put content in the Ashcans that probably should have gone into the main book. Just for that tiny bit of context kind of unlocked the whole thing for me. I love Grokken. I'm huge on Grokken now. It's one of my favorite things, and the art is just like mind-bendingly amazing.
Yeah.
Don't read, if you're an artist, don't read Grokken as an artist. You'll just want to stop. Like, read it as a fan enjoying this amazing achievement that is, you know, Kenneth's art. And I suspect it's going to be a big thing. I have super high hopes for it. Like I have high hopes for Battlebrick Road. Like I have high hopes for my own work. Yeah. And now maybe I'll have high hopes for Downcast as well. But it sounds like I'm coming in at about the right time. I'll only have to wait for one more book, it sounds.
Yeah. And this will be enough that you can sit down. You'll actually use the bookmark. You know,
It's not a lot of pages. I've got how many pages? 120 on the first one.
I figured it out once, but it's over 200 pages.
Yeah, that'll total. Take me a while.
Well over 200. Yeah. So it'll keep you reader. It'll keep you entertained for a while. So, but Kenneth Rocafort, he's also just a standout guy. You know, just the few exchanges I've had with him, he's just so awesome. Yeah.
He's like, hey, how you going? And he's like the best artist in comics, you realize.
Yeah.
You know, he's just like, oh, hi. Yeah. Mo says, if you don't know how to spell backer, Rob Arnold's Downscast might be my. Oh my
That's funny.
God, we always miss something when Mo is in the chat, and then he just swings right back into action, and we remember why he is the golden wrench. All right, let me do a final refresh here. I'm part of this, by the way.
That's awesome.
There we go.
Holy cow.
4,171.
Thank you.
Backers. Love it. Brilliant. 834% awesome. Funded. Yeah, I'm about to do this myself. Probably in May, I'm thinking now at this point. Mm. I'm going to chuck everything up onto Indiegogo, Kickstarter, fund my comic, and just sort of see how we go.
Yeah, circulate it. Yeah.
By that time, all the art will be, if not 100% done, you know, we'll be working on pre-press, getting very close to done. So I don't want to have to worry about production while I'm doing other things. So,
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome, man.
Again, another time that another reason why it's a good time that really not just finishing up the last, I think, 4 pages of colors. Yeah, that's it. So, and he's super reliable and yeah. So yeah, we're gonna be ready for lettering here really soon, and yeah, get it printed and get it out. It'll be awesome.
I'm about to send my letters to Eric as well. I love that part too, when you see all the letters in a professional way and everything.
Then it looks like a comic book.
Yeah, you're right. That's the first time it actually looks like a comic.
Yeah.
Now last week I caused a bit of a cock up. When I sent a raid to the cockfight and apparently screwed with the numbers. So this week, I'm not going to do that. Yeah, it screwed up with the voting. I'm going to send, but it's okay. I think Rini, who's streaming here? Yeah, Rini is streaming. So she's streaming in about 5 minutes. I think that's close enough. I will send everyone over there to Creative Block. You won't have to wait too long, hopefully. I don't know. I can't vouch, but I hope Narwhal and Alzamat having a good time over there on the cockfight. I'm going to go over there and check it out, see who I want to vote for. Maybe it's already all done. I don't even know. But Moses, I don't think it'll be an issue with Narwhal versus Al. Look, maybe it will. Who knows? Clint, it is always a pleasure to hang out with you, my friend. And likewise, congratulations on the ongoing success of Downcast. I can't wait to read it. Can't wait to receive it.
Yeah, you gotta let me know what you think when you're done reading it. I'm curious. So
usually, if I don't care for it, you just never hear from me.
That's fair.
But I heard so much good stuff from this. I'm expecting to enjoy this, and it is the genre that I most enjoy. So I'm thinking I'm gonna enjoy it. So
yeah. Cool. Yeah, I'm excited. That'll be good. Thank you. Appreciate you having me on and for backing and for everybody that supports me still, even without a YouTubing. So thank you.
My pleasure, man. Yeah, absolutely. It's all about great comics over here now. So that's what I'm focused on. All right, everyone, I'm going to let you go. Enjoy the rest of your night wherever you go. If you're going to the cockfight, if you are going to Creative Block or wherever you're going, enjoy it. I will see you tomorrow. Not sure what I'll be doing, but doing something. Maybe I'll read another book. That sounds good. That sounds like an idea. All right. Have a good night, everyone. Bye.
Bye.
Individually, we are weak, like a single twig. But as a bundle, we form a mighty fat. Thank you.